Hi everyone. So one of the most frequently asked questions in the equity markets is, how do we really identify companies worth investing in? Well, it is a very long drawn process. It involves a lot of hard work, experience, research, etc., etc. Here, in this video, we will give you a small glimpse of the kind of work that goes into such an identification that we teach in our fundamental analysis workshop, right? So today we will learn, how do you use financial ratios or accounting ratios to identify companies worth investing in? To do that, we will look at the greatness framework by Ambit Capital. We will learn this framework with an example. So let us say you start a business to sell Patanjali products. You want to set up a shop where you will sell only Patanjali products. Now, what would you have to do to start the shop? You will have to take a shop on rent. You will have to pay a deposit. You will have to build some kind of furniture. You will have to stock the entire shop with goods. What do you need for that? Well, you need capital, you need money that you need to invest in this business to start it off. So that is the first phase for any business. Once you have invested this capital, what do you expect? You expect people will come and buy these goods from you, buy these products from your shop. So your capital will get converted into sales. Now, what would a good business do? It will convert more and more capital into sales, or the velocity of conversion from capital to sales will be higher. How do you measure this velocity? You measure it by the asset turnover ratio. Next thing is, when you do these sales, obviously you want to earn a profit on them. Nobody wants to do a sale at a loss. So how do you really measure how profitable your sales are? Well, one of the ways to measure them is EBITDA margins. So first you start off with capital. You want your capital to get converted into sales. You want these sales to be profitable. Next comes an often ignored part, which is you want these profits to get converted into cash. Let's say you get a huge bulk buyer who is going to buy out your entire inventory of 20 products at one go. Obviously, you will love that because that means big sales, big profits, but that buyer makes a condition that I will pay you money after 3 months. You have to sell it to me on credit. What does this mean for you? For you, it means that though you have made the sales, you have booked the profit, but the money has not come into your hands. So on the next day of sales, what you have to do? You have to restock your shop. How will you restock that? Well, you have to shell out money from your pocket to actually get in more goods. Even though you have a big pile of profit sitting, but it's not yet converted into cash. So you have to pull out more capital from your pocket to invest it in your business. So it is very important that the profits that you are earning get converted into cash, or else to keep the business running, you will have to invest more and more capital. So how do you really assess how much of the profits are getting converted into cash? Cash flow from operations by EBITDA is one of the ways to look at it. Once a business is generating cash, you have two options from that. Either you can pull it out of the business or you can reinvest it in the business. In other terms, if the shop that you have opened starts generating cash, you can either take it out and spend it, go to a restaurant, buy a mobile phone, buy a laptop, or you can say that, listen, I'm doing well, so let me use this money to expand. After 6 months, I might have saved enough money to open another shop. So this is called reinvesting it back into the business. Now, when will a business owner decide to reinvest capital into the business? Well, when he or she is confident that you will get good profits on that capital. How do you really assess how profitable your capital investment is, or how efficiently is your capital deployed? One of the ways to look at it is ROCE, return on capital employed, right? So this completes the entire circle for a business. You start off with capital, you convert it into sales, then you convert it into profits, profits get converted into cash, and then cash again gets converted into capital. And you have a ratio to measure each stage, how effectively your conversion is happening. Now, companies who can repeat this cycle efficiently over and over again for years and years together are the companies which achieve greatness, or in other words, which create a lot of wealth for their investors. So guys, this is the greatness framework by Ambit. It is just one of the frameworks that you can really use to identify investable companies. Also remember, these ratios that we have talked about are just some of the ratios that you can use. There are multiple ways to look at investment ideas. There are multiple ways to assess companies for investment. And in this video, we have given you a small glimpse of what is possible and how it's done. Thank you so much.